Absolutely.
Thank you very much. I thought this is really an improvement on what we had before, and that's great thinking. But I was worried that the extent, the focus is still, you're covering lots of territory. When you read it, the places in Tanzania and DRC Congo, I think you're almost taking huge chunks of area. I don't know whether that's easy to do. Maybe you should narrow the focus even more.
I think the narrow bit that he has put, when he says Western Congo,
yeah.
We said in Western Congo, where do we go? Then we narrowed those groups.
So it's not the whole of Eastern Congo.
Yeah.
Well, yeah. They have given us some groups, and they will refine them so that they are actually small. Just like in Uganda, Eastern Uganda is affected, but we have narrowed to, what is that place called, right? Buruda. So that we narrow and then we cause impact.
So I think you just have to be conscious of, I don't know how big is East Kivu, North Kivu.
They are
huge. They are huge.
No, we don't want to.
Another way, perhaps, of looking at the concept of faith, right? Because my concern there would be, I'm not sure the ability for the RAN and for the universities involved to address, let's say, those root causes of conflict. A way perhaps to think about the conflict problem here is, what are the issues related to supporting populations affected by conflict? So you could look at populations that are displaced, right? You could look at the refugee populations, you could look at host communities who are impacted, and some of those challenges. So it is something to think about here where, you know, what can we do related to conflict where it's within more of our span of control and capacity? Not to say that you shouldn't deal with what you have on paper here, but as you start thinking about, you know, looking at it again on the resilience side, right? How do you make people resilient to conflict? What are we talking about here? But we might be able to make people more resilient to the impact of conflict in terms of how we provide assistance, how we promote processes related to providing for the protection and improve assistance, how we perhaps can build their capacity so that when they return home, right, they're more resilient. So just some thoughts about that.
That, I mean, if you're around that region, you realize two things. One is the border is very porous, and there is actually a lot of interaction over the border. And then secondly, there's a lot in the way of sort of conflict mitigation, etc., that would be potentially helpful, particularly given some of the partners we have here on our team from the U.S. side.
I think that as far as the conflict are concerned, we have to stress one thing. So far, the country, NGOs and other partners, has been trying to find solutions to the consequences.